Okay, welcome back, my dear student. Today we are going to start simple interest, though it is not in your book. Okay, instead of simple interest, compound interest is there in your book. So without knowing simple interest, it's difficult to understand compound interest. So in the last class, Monna sir, I think he has sent the PDF file with the formula, and formula is here. SI equals to PTR by 100, SI equals to A minus P. To find rate, 100 into SI divided by P into T, time is equal to 100 into SI divided by P into R, and P equals to 100 into SI divided by T into R. Now quickly we'll revise simple interest so that it will be easy for us to understand compound interest. Here I have taken one question where principal is 5000. Time is 2 years, rate is 10%, you have to find out SI and amount, okay? So first you apply this formula, SI equals to P into T into R divided by 100. So your principal is 5000 into time is 2 years into 10 divided by 100. So this and this cancel. 50 into 2, 100, 100 into 10 is 1000. 52 is 100, 100 into 10 is 1000. So 1000 is SI. Therefore, amount equals to, from this formula you have to derive. So amount equals to SI plus principal, or principal plus SI is same thing. 1000 plus principal is 5000 equals to rupees 6000. So in this way you have to do. You have already done this in class 7. This is just revision. Now next question, find the principal. That means you have to find out principal where amount. Find the principal will amount. Amount is 5000. Amount is 5000, and rate is 10%. 10%, and SI is 500. SI is 500. Time 2 years. Time 2 years. Principal you have to find out. Amount is 5000, rate 10%, SI is 500. Okay, now to find principal, formula is here. Principal equals to 100 into SI divided by rate into time. 100 into what is SI? SI is 500 divided by what is rate? Rate is 10 into time is 2. Simply apply the formula, put the value, will get the answer. This 0 and this 0 cancel. 2 5s are 10, 0. That means 50 into 50 is 2500. So principal is 2500. In this way you have to calculate. Let us do another question. All these are revision. All these are revision. Now question number 3. In how many years means you have to find out time. You have to find out time. Will rupees 950 produce as 399 as simple interest? Means simple interest is rupees 399 and principal is 950 and rate is 7%. So you have to find out time. Again apply the formula. Time equals to 100 into SI divided by rate into time, rate into principal. 100 into 399 divided by 950. 950 into 7. Now simply you have to calculate, you will get the answer. This and this cancel. 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5, 6 7 8 9 4, 5 9s are 45. After that, I think 399 and 19 is divisible. Okay, divide 399 by 19. 19 2s are 38. 9 minus 8, 1, bring this down, 19. That means 19 1s are 19. That means it will go 21 times. Again, 7 1s are 7, 7 3s are 21. So 2 3s are 6%. So in this way, you have to calculate. Now let us do one more question. Find the time. Again, you have to find out time where 1200 will amount to rupees 1536. Here amount is given. Again, you have to find out time. Amount is given 1536. 1536. Principal is given 1200. And rate is 3.5%. So before time, first you have to know simple interest. Without knowing simple interest, you will not get answer. So to find simple interest, you have to use this formula because amount and principal is given. Okay. So find out. SI equals to A minus P. 1536 minus 1200. Subtract it. 36, 5 minus 2, 3, 336. After that, find out time. Time equals to 100 into SI divided by rate into principal. 100 into 336 divided by principal is 1200 into rate is 3.5. So 3.5, remove the decimal, write 10 over here. Okay. Now, these two will get cancelled. 5 7s are 35, 5 2s are 10, 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12. Now, 6 5s are 30, 6 5s are 30, now 36, 6 6 are 36, 7 8s are 56. That means 8 years. So in this way you have to find out. Now we'll do rate. How to find rate? After that I will start compound interest basics. So last question from simple interest. At what rate percent means? Rate you have to find out. 630 produce an interest of 126. SI is given 126 and principal is given 630 and time is 4 years. Here SI is given, so you directly apply this formula. Rate equals to 100 into SI divided by P into T. 100 into SI means 126 divided by principal is 630 into 4. Okay, this and this cancel. I think these two will cancel. 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3, 3 4s are 12, 3 4s are 12, 3 2s are 6, 21 2s are 42, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. So answer is 5%. So I hope you understood simple interest. Here we have done how to find simple interest, how to find rate, how to find time, how to find principal. Now next chapter, which is on the syllabus for class 8, is compound interest. And in compound interest there are two exercises. One is formula method and another one is without formula method. So today we'll start without formula method. The first question is question will be find compound interest and amount. Okay, find compound interest and amount for rupees 5000 for 2 years, this is very important, for 2 years at the rate of 10%. At the rate of 10%. So here you have to find out compound interest and amount. Compound interest and amount. The only difference between simple interest and compound interest is time. In simple interest, whatever time is given will take same time. If it is 2 years, will take 2 years. If it is 3 years, will take 3 years. But in compound interest, whatever time is given, you have to break that time. Suppose 2 years means you have to do two times, first year and second year. If it is 3 years, that means you have to do three times. Okay, then you will write in this way, for first year, for first year, CI is equal to, formula remains the same, PTR by 100. What is principal? Principal is 5000. Time, since it is 2 years, I have told you, you have to do two times, means 1 year, 1 year, so time will be 1 into rate is 10 divided by 100. This and this cancel, this and this cancel, so 50 into 10 is 500. So 500 is compound interest for the first year. After that, you have to find out amount. Amount equals to, amount for the first year, amount equals to principal plus CI. So what is the principal? 5000 plus, what is CI? 500. So add it, you will get 5500. Now compound interest for the first year is rupees 500. Compound in amount for the first year is rupees 5500. Now this is very important. First year's amount will be second year's principal. It means amount for the first year is same as principal for the second year. Okay, that's very important. Now you find out second year. For second year, again compound interest, formula is same, PTR by 100, this time principal will be 5500 into 1 into what is the rate? 10 divided by 100, this and this cancel, this and this cancel, that means 550. Now amount for second year, this is answer number 2. Okay, suppose this is number 1 and this is number 2. Answer number 2, amount for the second year is 5500 plus 550. Add it, 50, 5 plus 5, 10, 6050 is amount for the second year. After that, you have to find out compound interest. To find compound interest, you have to add all the interest that you have got. For the first year, it was 500. Now in the second year, it is 5500. Therefore, total interest will be 500 plus 550 equals to rupees 1050. So 1050 is compound interest for the second year. Sorry, this is total interest for 2 years, not second year, 2 years. Compound interest for 2 years is 500 and 550. Add it, you will get the answer. Thank you very much. This much for today. We'll continue compound interest in the next class. Please revise simple interest and compound interest, at least this question. Thank you very much.